Hi, I'm Diana Burgess, and I'm known as Miss B around here. And we're going to talk about nursing math. When we look at nursing math, there's really just two formulas that you need to learn to be able to do all the different math type problems you're going to encounter throughout our entire program. So we're going to start with this one here called doctor order. This is where the doctor or a nurse practitioner or a PA orders a medication for one time, one dose. And then we have to know here in the second part of our equation, what is the available form? How does this come? Does it come in tabs? Does it come in capsules? Does it come in mils? And then of that form, what is the available dose? And then sometimes we'll need a conversion if we have unlike measurements. For instance, if we have grams to milligrams, milligrams to micrograms, or such. When you're thinking about the vehicle here, let's look at this. Let's say we have to take six students to the Tampa airport. And so we might have, that is our order, we need to get six students to the Tampa airport. Well, what's the vehicle? If I have a van, then I could just use one van to get all those six students to the airport. But if I only have a four-seater sedan, I'm gonna have to take at least two or one and a half. And if I have one of those little smart cars, right, that only takes two, we're gonna need three of them. So that's what we're looking at here. What is the vehicle? And then in each vehicle, how much medication is in each? So when you are finding out what the question is, always decide, what is it I'm looking for? Am I looking for mils? What is my available form? Am I looking for how many mils I'm going to give? How many capsules? How many tabs? How many suppositories? How many units? And that is the heart of the question. So you want to take out here, and whatever it is, mils, tabs, you want to circle it so that when you use dimensional analysis, once you're left with what you're looking for, you know you have it set up correctly, and then all you have to do is use your calculator. The second formula that we're going to talk about has to do with volume over time. Okay, it doesn't matter what's in the volume, it matters that there's a volume. For instance, if the doctor orders 1,000 milliliters of D5.5 normal saline with 40 milliequivalents of KCl to infuse over 8 hours, and we want to know how you would set the pump in mils per hour, then this is obviously a volume over time. Okay, and it doesn't matter what the volume is, doesn't matter what's in it, it matters how much over how much time. And then, again, we have a second part. We have the med over the available, whether it is mils, whether it's drops per minute. And then we might have to have a time conversion. If we're talking about hours to minutes, that's usually what's there. But again, always start it off for what I'm looking for. Am I looking for mils per hour? Or am I looking for drops per minute? Circle that so that when I am done setting up my problem, if I am left with that, then I'm doing right. And remember, always put your vehicle, what you're looking for, in the second part of this equation to help you. Now, just to give you a little help with equivalencies, we have this little triangle up here, okay? Grams, milligrams, micrograms. So, I have a goofy little saying that I like to use. Grandma drove 1,000 miles in her little MG, yes, 1,000 miles, to get to the microbrewery to enjoy some of the million brews, okay? So whatever helps you remember that there are 1,000 milligrams in a gram, there are 1,000 micrograms in a milligram, and there are 1,000,000 micrograms in a gram. And that's as easy as it is.